get her rally ball going.
Yeah, you, babe. Yeah, I said, did you want something to eat? You want to make a... I was going to make a bap or something. What? So what are you doing then? You're going to Pirate Park? Who with? Oh, okay. Because I was going to take Margot swimming. Then I'm just going to find out now.
This is an important message for people living with diabetes. From people living with diabetes.
When I was experiencing the symptoms of diabetes, I didn't know what was going on.
You go on the internet and it's full of horror stories.
I didn't understand about carbs. I didn't understand about the glucose levels.
That's why the support I get as a diabetes UK member is so important.
Is it Fiery Grange or Lodge?
When you do, you will receive a practical guide specific to your type of diabetes and a copy of
the magazine.
Yeah. Right, babe. What time are you going?
Yeah,
I need to move my van then. Right, it's 4-3. 4-3, Pavlyuchenkova.
Sunny in the world of Anastasia Pavlyuchenkova at the moment, for the way she has turned this set around, winning the last four games. Now the game has been tight.
I've parked behind you.
Stood up to it, and she has meaningful
strikes. A favourite Russian player. Oh, lovely serve. And yeah, I'll come here a sec.
Yeah.
Look, this is exactly what I'm talking about here. Watch. Now, her serve is completely different to Sabalenka's serve. But look, watch. Look at her shoulders. Look how she opens her shoulders. Watch. Opens her shoulders. Yeah, see. So it looks fast that she's hitting flat, but she's not. She's hitting across the ball. But you're not going all the way out. What you're doing is you're going out. Hello, yeah. What time's family swim today, please, at Friary? Half past one to half past three, yeah. And my daughter plays tennis. My daughter does swimming at Burntwood, so that means she's free, isn't it? Yeah. But I've got to pay for myself, haven't I? Which is...
Yes, you have. Yeah.
Is it 480, yeah?
It is, yeah.
Okay, cool. And do I need to book or do I just turn up?
You just turn up.
Okay, and what time is family swim tomorrow as well, please?
It's 11:15.
Oh, 11:15 tomorrow, yeah?
Yeah.
And is tomorrow going to be more busier than today, probably, or...? Oh, okay.
No, I just don't know, I'm afraid.
Oh, so just basically get there early.
Yeah,
No, get there early as in be the... Yeah. Okay, all right, thanks then.
Bye.
Cheers, bye. Sabalenka can really hit through this ball. Oh, what are we now? Juice. 13 unforced errors from Sabalenka. 6 to Pavs.
Oh, dear. Big day of tennis today. Serena Williams as well.
She's done it again. Put that serve down the tee. Yeah. Arms! Just come and do my live for me while I just move the car. All right. Look, you need to film this. Look. Just look at this serve again. Same motion, same end result. Open the shoulders, down the tee. Yeah? Yeah. Just do my live for me. Amelie's taking over.
Right, let's go. Let's get down to business.
Hello.
Right, we've got to record that bit because it showed a re. Say something, Hams, man.
I am. I'm just watching at the moment.
Say Sabalenka's return,
sir. I don't normally watch Sabalenka that much. I haven't been watching much tennis recently, but.
And for the second time in a row, she's gone to win the game.
Watched a few men's matches yesterday. I really like Sabalenka as a player. I've watched her a couple of times, actually. She's quite powerful. My dad often compares me to, wants me to watch her to make improvements like her. Lovely serve.
Sliding the serve out wide, the second serve, but still at pace.
Okay, have a good time. Sabalenka to serve. You see how Sabalenka really opens up her shoulders?
Yeah.
Oh.
Okay, come on, Dad, because I need to get ready. Thanks, guys. I wonder if
there's this chat with older brother Alexander that must have been alive in there. Keep making one more ball. Don't get too proud about it.
Interesting to see how Sabalenka, she was playing fine at the start of the match, but copes when things aren't going so well, or when the A game isn't there. Because none of the players played 7 perfect matches.
She's got such a powerful serve, but when she goes for the shots after,
it's not so good.
Hit or miss, whether it's going to go in or into the net.
On their bad days. That's what separates them from the good players.
Thanks, guys. Bye. Dad, come on!
She loves an open space, doesn't she, Sabalenka?
much because she's seen the opening. On that occasion,
Dad!
Cross court was a winner. She thinks she's hit an ace here, which has been called out. But it is on the line. Francois Lutz says the call was wrong. And Sabalenka breaks the sequence of games against her.
It's 5-4 now.
Hard to believe that was me. Now I've got a family of my own, it's my job to protect their future.
Welcome to Smart Life Insurance.
Hey, Ams, you can go now.
Okay, thanks.
Did you say anything?
Yeah, I did say nothing.
You didn't say nothing, love.
Yes, I did.
Yeah,
I'm
so cool on that, Ams.
Yeah, please. It's been a set of twists and turns. Games in a row. And does have the opportunity to serve out the set. At least Sabalenka has a game on the board to end that sequence.
Taking a little off her first serve. So what I'm really pleased about Pavlyuchenkova is how well she's played behind her second serve. Historically, it gets a little soft and spinny, and she doesn't win too many points behind it. But she's had good numbers behind it today.
Sort of game you like when you're serving for a set. Pavlyuchenkova from 3 love down takes the opening set of this third round match.
Pika sponsors ITV's coverage of Roland Garros. Yes, welcome to your universe. Here you can see if money can take you. Talk with a Barclays money mentor to make a plan to get you there. Talk to a Barclays money mentor and make money work for you. When crafting our electrified range of hybrid and all-electric vehicles, we ask one question. How does it feel?
Barbecuers, Ocado's got some sizzling deals. Come rain or shine, charred sausage lovers get 3 for £10 on our barbecue bundle and bottles of Heinz ketchup for just £1. However long it takes to get the barbecue lit, There's Ricardo just for you.
There you are then, Paris, France on a Friday morning. But we're going to test your knowledge of East Europe for the next 10 seconds or so because we're heading around a couple of courts. Here's Kazakhstan against Russia. This is Elena Rybakina, who's the 21st seed against Elena Vezhnina. And you can see that the Kazakh is set for good and it's two apiece in the second. And as we head to court seven, we've got Slovenia against the Czech Republic here. This is Tamara Zidanzic against Katarina Siniakova. Siniakova took the first set, a whitewash, 6-love. In the second set. Now off to court 14, Norway against Spain. And this is Casper Ruud, the 15th seed, against Alejandro Davidovich Fokina of Spain. Have a look to see if he's the longest name in the draw, actually. Just comparing him with Anastasia Pavlyuchenkova. So that's quite significant. Anyway, it's 4-3 to Ruud at the moment. So let's go back to Pavlyuchenkova. Feeling an awful lot better than she was after the first three games, back to Sam and John.
Absolutely, and Sabalenka back from a little break off court. What did Pavlyuchenkova do really well there, Sam, to withstand the power that was coming at her, especially in those first three games?
That I don't think is a problem for Pavlyuchenkova because she's very loads very well on her legs. You've got to sort of hold your body firm and sit down in your legs to stop yourself being pushed back. Apart from a few sort of gruff looks at her brother. I didn't catch her. I don't know if that's about talking to her brother. Anyway, what she didn't do was panic. And actually, all that was about Sabalenka. You just got completely carried away at 3-love. You just started spraying more balls everywhere.
Better, isn't it, from Sabalenka? You get the feeling this is going to be an exercise in restraint, more than anything.
And a difficult one as well. She's a wholehearted tennis player, fairly freewheeling. You know, that needs to impose some structure and some discipline into what she's going to do for the next 30 or 40 minutes.
Emily! You're on the phone, are you getting ready?
We mustn't forget this is a player still learning the game. They're only 23 years of age, relatively fresh. Grand Slam level. And that was a much, much better game from her. Just since she shaped up all those big forehands, thinking to herself, I don't have to hit this 200 mile an hour. And it worked. And it's nice when she gets 200 mile an hour going. Of course it is.
I always think it's quite amusing, actually. She talks about the coaching she had early on in Belarus as a teenager, and she was not terribly complimentary about it. She says, they just told me to hit the ball as hard as I possibly could. That was it. And they didn't think she was any good either. They didn't believe in that.
That's nice. She's proved them wrong.
That is her driver. Positive when she comes forward, she'll put her bodies, lovely hands. back at her. There's a couple now on those forehand bars. I like the way Sabalenka spent at the forehand body, which is not as good as the backhand body. That's what I call doing your homework before you come onto the match court. That's how you play Serena. You always try and pass it down the forehand side. That side is not as strong. More homework that we've done. Sabalenka will be ready for Pavlyuchenkova to take the ball down the line. You see, Pavlyuchenkova, she likes to trade cross court, but as soon as there's something to hit down the line, it's almost like she's playing on a hard court. She goes for it.
Yo, I'm back. Right, let's get this logged in.
Third round of the Women's Championship, last 32. Some good matchups.
6-4 Pavi first set. What kind of word is that? First set. And it's 1-1 second set. Unos, unos, 1-1. Sabalenka serving. Oh dear. Pavi just hit one long. Big dog having some breakfast, man. Sabalenka crushes those return to serves, man.
Really well on the court. And that was, if you go down the center, you have to go a little deeper than that, but there was some work to do there for Sabalenka.
Sometimes the LTI going live. Oh, love 30. Ah, 15-30.
Good
day. Mm. This is some of the best seen
from Pavlyuchenkova in a while. In terms of her serving performance. Is it the final today? Oh, that's a big miss. In a couple of times, in the first point of the game, she had a second serve. Just missed it long down the line. It's going to be these little moments. Yeah, she knows it. In the second service, I've like, you've got to make it count. You don't have to hit a winner.
Sabalenka's on the board. Taking the lead. 2-1 lead. 2-1 lead. Saba in the second. Nah, Saba's doing well, man. Pavi to serve. If it goes with serve, it's going to go 2-0, but it's 2-1. I really like how Pavlyuchenkova uses her legs. Eva versus Rana today. That's going to be good. Oh, going for the serve out wide. Oh dear, well, she made it. Went for the running cross court forehand and she made it, must have just clipped the line.
She was nowhere. I mean, really the obvious shot was just a little drop shot down the line, a little push down there. She's perfectly capable of opening up the racket face. Just starting to get a little jittery with that second serve. That's what always worries me. Throughout the course of the season, she's only won about 70%. She'd love 70%, 40% of her points behind the sort of second serve. You really need to be up in the 50s. 50 if.
Two all now.
In or around the top 20 between about 2012 and 2018. Since 2018, more like around the 30 mark. Still elite stuff.
I think this game's going to go with serve all the way, you know. I've just got a feeling. Sabalenka's legs look so strong. Great serve. Oh dear. Pavi's footwork sometimes really lets her down. Sabalenka serves long. So it's second serve. It's just bouncing the ball. Let's have a look at it in motion. Yeah, in's nice and slow. Oh, put it right back down her. Punners?
Much better return. The return I love on a clay court is something about you don't, I'm saying you don't have to hit a winner on clay. You just want to really stop them getting onto their first shot behind the serve, particularly the Sabalenka forehand.
30-15 on the Sabalenka serve. Needs depth. Oh, I was just about to say she needs depth. And then Pavi hits one into
like
net.
To see Pavlyuchenkova. I mean, there's threats either side from Belarus. I'd really like to see her try and neutralize that serve and then first shot forehand. Try and get the return onto the Belarusian's backhand if possible.
Oh dear. She's trying to Serena.
Simple service hold
in a row for the number three seed, Sabalenka 3-2. What a serve! That ball just blew! 3-2. This summer, be someone that braves the shade for McMillan Cancer Support. I'm braving the shade for my family.
Saba.
My family members got diagnosed with cancer, turned my world upside down. Without McMillan, I don't know how we would have to do it. Get sponsored by friends and family to help us be right there for everyone living with cancer.
Friendly Bishop has been amazing. It's an experience that's been there for a very long time. If you're considering Braving the Shade, go for it.
Sign up today at bravetheshade.org.uk.
You can check your eligibility for an Acro credit card without affecting your credit score. We say yes to over 4,000 people every week, even when other lenders may have said no. We could say yes to you too. That's because at Acquin, we know you're more than your credit score. If you're ready to build better credit, why not start today? Check your eligibility at acquicard.co.uk. Representative 37.9% APR variable.
Any questions? No questions? Keep in touch with events over on Court Philippe Chatrier because they're about to begin. All smiles, Victoria Azarenka and Madison.
Oh, what a match. Azarenka Keys. I'm going there after this, trust me. Long. Pavi's second serve. They've been playing for an hour. Really slows down that second serve, but gives us up a nice angle. Slice. Running forehand from Sabalenka. Couldn't get enough on it, puts it in the net.
Look at it. It's the third quarter as you read down from the top. So either Sabalenka or Pavlyuchenkova here will play either Azarenka or Keys to play potentially Serena Williams in the quarterfinals.
Mm. Oh, lovely shot. Lovely. I need to record that. Where's the...
useful players as well. In that section, don't write off Daniel Collins today against...
Oh, yeah, the All-American.
Here we go, please. That's what I'm trying to teach, Emily. Is that footwork? And I was waiting for this low man. Just look at the footwork. Look. Now, as it's coming over, look at the footwork, look at the setup. All body.
Sabalenka right now seeing way too many forehands, really. Pavlyuchenkova's liking. I don't worry about Pavlyuchenkova. I think she's a great front runner, but I think she plays very well from behind as well. A serve that is wobbling, isn't it? That's not good enough. Not for a first serve.
First break points of the set. Sam mentioned that Pavlyuchenkova may have been feeling the pressure in her previous service game. Got through that one just. But not that time. Had to come back well and truly on now.
Pavlyuchenkova's just come off her first serve. It's gone from a sort of a three-quarter well-placed first delivery to sort of a semi-cream puff being put in the box. And you just can't do that. Just lost a little confidence in it.
Mm. Right, people. I've just got to open the window. Then we're back in. 4-2, Sabalenka winning the second set. Wait there. Right, Sabalenka to serve, 15-0. Improve, adapt, overcome. Oh, it's come for the tea. Who's this?
Hi, Lisa. I haven't yet. I think number four is that down there, isn't it? I don't know. Why have they put him through? Because we're five.
Did he catch that
one?
He was cleaning his sunglasses. That is even more.
Yeah, impressive. It could be then. Yeah, I'm sure. I think it's the one on the corner. No, that one there. Good luck.
Oh, she gets away with that, Sabalenka, because she'd missed five serves in a row. That's two double faults of the set. Pavlyuchenkova is so sure about that.
Oh, she's having her umpires out.
Well, look, quite a big delay. I have to remember where the mark was. Left me out, though.
Oh, lovely. Cross court backhand, beautiful.
It really has helped Sabalenka that Pavlyuchenkova has just not been getting enough length on these returns.
Ah, drop shot. So Sabalenka goes 5-2 ahead. Right, she'll break her serve now. Win this next game. 6-2, but yeah.
You got it!
I can't believe my girl's been sleeping with a grown man. I can't believe it's happening to innocent little girls. It's just terrifying. It's absolutely shocking that there are girls out there who are having to go through this.
Right now, girls are being forced to suffer at the gym. They're being made to marry men, sometimes more than three times their age.
That's why I knew I had to sponsor Anna.
Please, would you sponsor a girl? So many need you to stand by them.
I sponsor a child called Sarah.
She's aware that she has choices and options in life. She has a brighter future. To receive letters and then to complete the experience by visiting Sarah in her community has been amazing.
Our sponsors change lives and you can too. Just text Stan to 88822 or search Stan with her.
I just want Katia to go up and be a strong independent woman, to stand up for herself and to be anything in the world that she wants to be.
Just over an hour played and Pavlyuchenkova is serving to stay in the second set. Sabalenka hit close to forcing a decider.
For me, it feels like a really important game for the Russian. Just keep investing. It's hard to stop Sabalenka juggernaut. It really is. It's all like when Serena gets going. Unless it stops itself, like it did in the first set of 3-love.
She's really seeing these backhands right now, isn't she? And 2 points away now.
But also, this is actually quite a safe return. It's not that close to the line. Plenty of margin for it. That's what I would call a great clay court return. That's playing for position to set up the net shot, because faster players than Pavlyuchenkova will get that and there'll be another shot to hit. And that's really good, in my mind, clay court tennis.
Three backhand winners in the game from Irina Sabalenka, and she has 3 set points.
Here we go. I told ya she'll win this 6-2, then Sabalenka will win the whole match. Boom! Absolutely hit through forehand, put it away. So, Sabas won 6-2. 6-2, second set. Oh, my tea.
When I was 10, I'd play football on my own in the back garden, and sometimes at school. I'd get angry when we'd lose, or when people wouldn't pass, and I'd storm off. It took a while to find a proper team that understood me, but we did. And I listened to my coaches, learned new skills, discovered that no team wins every game. No player scores with every shot. But most importantly, I learned how to lose as well as win. I'm 12 now and seen my team progress. So when my mates make mistakes, I don't get angry. I help them up and we carry on. Another chance will come.
Well, the clouds gather, but mercifully, no more rain to follow the downpour that they had at 8 o'clock this morning, our time. And here we are with a really intriguing...
Oh, yeah, Azarenka Keys.
Victoria Azarenka.
Oh, and Madison Keys.
You have just struck how many players in Belarus. Is there some huge sort of factory somewhere in Minsk that they just churn out players? It's just amazing. Anyway, Keys 2-1 to the good early stages there.
on Suzanne Longlen. Rybakina the 21st seed is putting out Vezhnina of Russia. 6-1, 6-4. This is the deciding point. With a pretty emphatic drive down the line.
And she won.
You always feel when somebody celebrates like that or under celebrates, they're thinking, I'm not done yet. I've got a long way to go in this tournament. On the court seven.
So Rybakina. Oh, women this morning. Zidansk Siniakova. Oh, Zidansek. I quite like Zidansek. But Siniakova's a strong player, man. But Coco Gauff beat her, didn't she? Oh, dear.
As indeed, could be the match on court 14 when Casper Ruud and Davidovich Fokina of Spain.
Davidovich. I love that name. Davidovich.
Salisbury and Rajiv Ram are a set down against Nice of Montenegro and Quetz of Germany, but they're three apiece in the second set. And Gordon Reid is playing his first round men's wheelchair singles against Shingo Kunieda, the number one seed from Japan, and that's in a first set tie break. But Gordon Reid is a mini break now. So let's go back to Pavlyuchenkova against Sabalenka.
Medical timeout. Pavlyuchenkova is having a medical timeout. Let's just have a little look at the keys match.
Yeah, so if there's anything, I mean, her serving numbers plummeted through that second set. She wasn't really hitting her serve. But it's all guesswork.
Jonathan, yes, Sam, either. Countries like Belarus, do they have huge junior programs which create all these players?
No.
I'm not really up to date with what happens in Belarus. I mean, certainly everything will be centered around Minsk. What I can tell you is that for Sabalenka, no one thought she was any good. And if it hadn't been for a sponsor that thought she was, that there was something there at 13 or 14, you wouldn't see her now. They lose a lot of players, the good players, because there isn't any money. If you think about Azarenka, she had to move, I think, at 12 to Spain and then to a Belarusian hockey player's house in Arizona to train. So I think it's all done by mainly family. The federation certainly has very little money. But I'll tell you the one thing that really has helped, that it was very difficult, I think, at the breakup of the Soviet Union. Any system that was in place completely fell apart for a long time. So it's all done privately. But about that time, there was a new mayor of Minsk. You will love this, John.
Yes.
And he was a massive tennis fan. And so I don't think the roads got fixed for a while, but he certainly...
He had his priorities right.
I think they certainly have a new tennis center now in Minsk. And it's actually, the sport is really booming there because of the Fed Cup. They made the Fed Cup final, which was played in Minsk, that was about 3 or 4 years ago, with Sabalenka in it. That's one of the first times that we saw her. And they had 10,000 attend each day. It was massive news. And of course, Azarenka is a huge star. And you think about Maximini, probably the first Belarusian that we saw sort of coming out of that part of the world. And he went to the States. Mm. So tell you what they do, they support each other. I know Azarenka, she had a very difficult time early on trying to make it, and she's very supportive of all the other Belarusians, as has Max Mirny. So I think it's a case, there isn't a lot, but they help each other.
Anastasia
Pavlyuchenkova.
And this is not
Pavlio.
If you contrast it with the National Tennis Center that we have in this country and all the sort of systems that we have in Loughborough and in Stirling and everything else, and you wonder how countries like Belarus can actually keep producing players, not just numerically, but actually top players as well. And maybe, you know, we have the same old conversation year on year about the inner drive and whether there's, you know, this is the way to get out of a certain circumstance. But it does seem also to the outsider that actually a lot of the people from the Eastern European countries who do well kind of come from middle class backgrounds in the first place in that context as well. Is that fair to say?
I think it is, yeah. A lot, there has to be some money somewhere, sponsors,
if they can get a big sponsor early on, that makes a huge difference. I don't know what it is though, everything is earned for these players, and they sort of grab on to whatever they can, and even when they are good juniors, and Sabalenka certainly wasn't, and they're not heralded. It's like, well, you haven't done anything yet. No one's, you know, patting them on the back. And that conversation, we, I mean, they all say, Eastern Europeans, you know, we don't have really any tournaments in our part of the world. We don't get wild cards. We have to start in the qualifying of the, you know, 128 draw of a $15,000 event, you know, in Tbilisi or somewhere, and fight their way through. And I think that builds incredible resilience. We've had the conversations all week. Resilience is just one of the most important, well, for anything really, but to be a tennis player, they are so tough.
Well, here comes Pavlyuchenkova. And let's hope she's in as close to 100% nick as she can be.
Right, Pavlyuchenkova's back.
And this match, obviously, you know, fascinating equalizer as we head into the final.
Right, great comments, man. Great comments, and I agree. Let me just text.
Is able to be competitive in this deciding set. Doesn't look the happiest, does she? First game here might tell us a lot.
Oh, why the go for the serve out wide? Be aggressive, go for the serve down the tee. Put them under pressure straight away. Oh, see? Double fault. I just don't get it. Like Coco Gauff the other day, serving aggressively down the tee. I think in the whole match, three set match, serve three double faults. Tell you what, she does such a good, what's this? Family Cup LTI Youth. Oh, what's this? You can still.
There's a biting point, isn't there, with Sabalenka, where she tries to hit the ball too hard and sort of loses the thread.
Oh, it's long.
I might mix my metaphors there.
So 15:30.
There's a point where she over revs and loses control.
Two double faults in the game.
Two double faults.
And, well, Pavlyuchenkova, who had to leave the court to have that left thigh pretty heavily strapped, hasn't had to do much in this game to find herself a break point.
Oh, she's got two break points. Sabalenka does not want to start this first game in the third set with two double faults. All second serving. Lovely. She got herself back to 30-40. What's this? I don't know.
Wow. She's faced with any kind of threat, Sabalenka. This is why she's so enjoyable to watch. A little bit spine of taking a step back. She's a front foot. Kind of
front foot player, yeah. It's the only way to be. Oh. Second serve, first serve in the net. Pavlyuchenkova's calm. Steps forward aggressively again. Forehand cross court, comes into the court. Backhand, takes out the court. She's going to go for the smash. Boom, she's won it. So 1-0 Pavi. She broke a serve, so broke Sabalenka first serve. Broke server first game. First game, third set.
Wow.
contest. See, the only thing is, if Pavlyuchenkova does win this match, I don't think Pavlyuchenkova's then got enough to beat Udia, Azarenka, or Madison Keys. So I just can't see if she's got enough game to then do that again. Whereas Sabalenka will just start where she finishes off, like that. First return of serve point, cross court winner, boom. Oh, she's in. She's lobbed that. What a lob from Sabalenka. Dream lob.
Sabalenka to get her moving away from the ball rather than onto it.
Oh, frustration's getting in because she knows just one little more step, one more inch. Yeah, she's just doing it now, everyone. She knows that one more inch, and that's in. Still 15-30. 30 all.
There's a stark difference, isn't there, between the two? Got so much feel on this backhand side.
To be fair, Pavi has got lovely hands though, hasn't she? Great serve down the tee. Pavlyuchenkova. Oh, she's a passing shot. Oh, so now Sabalenka's got a break point. Hits it long. Now juice. Sabalenka really needs to break back and get back on serve. It's now juice. Dearie me. Come on, a juice. Let's look after this ball now, Saba. Look after this ball. She's going to go across court. Yes, oh, she's done it. She hasn't done it, sorry. Advantage Pavlyuchenkova.
We've had several fine winners on both sides of the net.
I think that was a fascinating point, though, because look at the width that Pavlyuchenkova got. You might have just seen Sabalenka tracking either side, was not sliding off either leg and got completely out of position. And that's what happens. When you don't slide, you can't get back in, and eventually you'll run out of court.
True love down now. She's put it in the net. She's gone for a forehand cross court angle shot and she's put it in the net.
Credit to Anastasia
Oh dear. Oh dear, Sabalenka's mind's all over the place. She needs to get herself back into.
Pavlyuchenkova is staying on a level as Sabalenka implodes somewhat. And how about this? Love 40.
Is that 3-0 down after like 8 minutes? Double break. 3-0 after 11 minutes. 3 level after 11 minutes.
EU citizens living in the UK by 31st of December 2020, you must apply to the EU settlement scheme, even if you have permanent residence. Check if you need to apply for your children, even if you have already applied for yourself. There is support available, including a helpline. The deadline is 30th of June 2021, so time is running out. If you don't apply, you could lose your existing rights to live, work, and access free healthcare and benefits in the UK. Apply today at gov.uk/EU settlement scheme.
Sabalenka held her serve throughout the second set without being taken to deuce. And yet she's dropped both service games early in this deciding set. And what a position for Anastasia.
No post for me, man.
Former quarterfinalist here. Although you have to go back 10 years for that.
You got something for me? Oh. Yeah, please, darling. Thank you. You're right. Yeah, good, good. It was brilliant what they were saying about Sabalenka, because she basically, as a junior, she had no junior record. And no one in Minsk really rated her until she was like 13. And then what happened was she had a sponsor, and the sponsor basically paid for her to go to Spain, where she obviously went to an academy in Spain and just hit loads of balls as hard as she could, and that was it. And she made it, and here she is playing Grand Slam, third seed. Because basically they were saying, do they have like some big academy in Minsk or something, as to why there are all so many players from Minsk? And well, the truth is that her, Saskovich, Azarenka, all left Belarus to go and train somewhere else. But the interesting thing is, they're all it's all privately done. It's all privately sponsored. It's all through sponsors. It's not through the Belarus Tennis Federation, because they've got no money. So that's basically what they were saying.
It was brilliant what they were
saying about Sabalenka, because she basically, as a junior, she had no junior record, and no one in Minsk really rated her until she was like 13. And then what happened was she had a sponsor, and the sponsor basically paid for her to go to Spain, where she obviously went to an academy in Spain and just hit loads of balls as hard as she could, and that was it. And she made it, and here she is playing Grand Slam, 13. Because basically they were saying, do they have like some big academy in Minsk or something, that, as to why they're all so many players from Minsk. And well, the truth is that her, Saskovich, Azarenka, all left Belarus to go and train somewhere else. But the interesting thing is, it's all privately done. It's all privately sponsored. It's all through sponsors. It's not through the Belarus Tennis Federation, because they've got no money. So that's basically what they're saying.
I think we're seeing just a few of the weaknesses in the game, because if she can't take a full colour she doesn't really play it.
Four love, Pavi. This is going, Pavli. This is going the wrong way. This is going the opposite way to what I predicted. I predicted Sabalenka would win the second set, which she did. And then from there, it would be Sabalenka taking the third set, but she can't keep the ball in court. She should get some confidence and belief at long. Second serve, love 15 down. Second serve, game 5 in the third. Ah. No, I don't know. I'd check that.
Top seed Ash Barty retired yesterday. The number 2 seed Naomi Osaka pulled out after a first round match. The world number 3 Halep isn't here. She's injured. Also out.
Yeah, she's on the board. Saba's on the board. I think if she gets on the board now, right, well, she's 30-15 ahead at the moment. Good serving. Ah, 30-all. She keeps hitting in the net.
Just feel this is a huge moment. We might be looking back in almost a week's time saying this was the moment, you know, where she held here and then found a way back.
I tell you who's disappointed to me, the German girl, Andrea Petkovic. I just think that she just massively underachieves. I just think she's an underachiever. Let me see where she's from. Petkovic. Because it does seem very
Well, it was a brilliant return off what was an excellent second serve from Sabalenka.
No way, she got another break point to go 5 love up. And see, that's it, she's done it, 5 love.
Brilliant
break point again for Anastasia Pavlyuchenkova to establish a 5-love lead.
Oh, she's gonna hit a ball out the stadium. So she's gonna get in trouble for that. 5-love down after 19 minutes. Jeez.
We'd do anything for the people we love. That's why I chose over 50 life insurance for Roland.
The money left behind can be used as a gift or to help pay for a funeral,
which could cost nearly £4,000.
Thanks, Mom.
We simply make affordable monthly payments.
So we can get on with the important things in life.
Royal London's over 50 life insurance has a 5-star rating from DeFacto, which is the highest rating we get.
Thanks, Mom.
Life can be uncertain, but it helps to know Royal London have been looking after families for over 150 years.
At Roland, we want to help you out the ones you love. Anyone aged 50 to 80 is guaranteed acceptance with no medical questions. You're fully insured after just 1 year. Too many people already trust us to help protect their families. Buy over 50 life insurance today, and if you pay £7 a month or more, you'll get a £100 welcome gift. Offer ends the 18th of June. Visit royallondon.com/gift.
Call 800-500-3311. We're about to see the latest big upset of Roland Garros 2021. So, number 3 seed, game away from defeat.
Oh, yeah.
The thing is, Sam, it'll now be a story either way, won't it? Either the seed will go, or she'll have come back from 5-love down in the final set.
Love 15. Pavlyuchenkova serving. Azarenka looking to save. Oh, 15-all. Sabalenka so looking to save her Roland Garros, but it's not looking good at the moment. Yeah, but I think Sabalenka will give her enough errors in order to
put a few more balls in court, which is really the essence of this game.
Yeah, you got to keep the ball in the court.
Down the line, then cross court, just missing. 2 points away.
Oh, take your time. First serves in the net. Take your time again. Let's have a look. Oh. See, against any normal player, these shots are in. But Pavlyuchenko is such a good defender. Oh, she's hit the net and it's come over. Oh, 30-all. 30-all. 5-love, Pavly. What time's the Serena Williams match? Well, she's got match point now. Pavi's got match point. On her serve. Oh yes, come on. Make her work for it. Make her work for it, Sabalenka. Oh no. Smashed it long. So Pavlyuchenkova's won. Le 6 season.
From the women's singles third round in just a second. We're heading off to see what's happening between Victoria Azarenka
and Madison Keys.
Via checking in on a strange old game
of Siniakova.
The Zantec of Slovenia lost the first set 6-love to Katarina Siniakova of the Czech Republic, but turned it round by winning the second set tiebreak 7-5, and now has a break of serve in the third set as well. So all sorts of strange games on in matches on this first Friday. On the court 14. And Casper
Ruud,
the 15th seed, lost the first set.
Oh, so Pavlyuchenkova wins. Oh, I'm tired this morning.
Here's some disappointing news from a British perspective. Joe Salisbury and Raji Brand have been so impressive in grandstands of late. Have gone out at the second round stage to main doubles to Nice of Montenegro and Fex of Germany. Throw a question at you, Sam. I mean, obviously, it doesn't explain or excuse wild forehands that just disappear.
Emily! What cause Leslie got?
Don't you think that last match was an indication, because all sport is about momentum and rhythm, indicated again with the issue about medical timeouts, which Pavlyuchenkova has said, you know, she was off court for a long old while. If you're in the ascendancy, you lose that sense of power and authority, and suddenly the whole game just shifts.
So what time is Leslie coming?
The final last year, John, not that long ago, and Sophia Kinnin took a medical timeout when that set 3-1
to Azarenka Keys.
And she was away for 5 or 10 minutes, and Siobhante hit a few serves. I think she hit a few balls with the ball
kick. Right, I'm going to end this stream, then come back doing the Azarenka Keys stream. Right, catch you in a minute. See you in a bit, guys. Bye-bye.